You know, in the studios, a lot of the great symphony players never get calls in the studio, unless the symphony is recording, but they hardly get studio calls. They don't get to work on movies and television and records and so forth. Once in a while, someone will hire a specialist from the symphony to play a particular aria or a particular score that they've written that's very important to the movie. So there's a great story about a clarinet player with the symphony. He gets a call from one of the great conductors. Nelson Riddle calls him in, and he says, gives him the parts and everything. It's a big orchestra, and he just plays the hell out of this clarinet. It's absolutely beautiful. And when they finish, he goes to Nelson, and he says, "Mr. Riddle, do you mind if I hang around? I'd like to hear the playback, see how my clarinet went." He said, "Harry, you did fine. You did a beautiful job. Fill out your W-4. You can leave now. We're going to have playbacks. This is a very low-budget film." He said, "But gee, Mr. Riddle, I'd really like to hear. I don't get to hear myself very often." He said, "I'm sorry. There's nothing we can do about it." He said, "Well, what's the name of the movie? Maybe I could see the movie when it comes out." "Harry, you don't want to see this movie. This particular movie is a heavy-duty pornographic movie. You did a beautiful job. Fill out your W-4. Thank you." "But Mr. Riddle, what's the name of the movie? Well, the name of the movie is Shirley and the Dogs." Well, the guy leaves. Well, a couple months later, he's driving down through the porno section of Santa Monica Boulevard in Hollywood, and it's a grand opening, Shirley and the Dogs. It's 2:00 in the afternoon. "There's that movie. I got to see that movie." Pulls in a parking lot, runs across the street, puts his collar up, pays his $7.50, and he walks in. He's sitting there, and he can't believe what he's seeing. He's seeing this woman with all these dogs, and I mean, they're doing everything unimaginable and everything imaginable. It's the most outrageous orgy he's ever witnessed in his life. And all of a sudden, the movie's over, and the lights come on, and there's an elderly couple sitting next to him. And he looks at him, and he says, "I don't usually come to these places, but I was playing the clarinet. I just wanted to hear the music. I just wanted to hear my music in the background." And this old lady looked at him. She said, "We never come here either. We just came here to see our dog."